Both buildings had stained glass, given in memory of mom and dad, given in honor of our aunt and uncle. This was grandma's window. Can you imagine leaving all of that behind? They understood something profound about God's new thing, is that to embrace God's new thing, one of the things that's required is to forget the former things. Honor the former things, but leave them in the past and step into the future. A powerful and beautiful thing. God is calling Israel through the prophet Isaiah to start to notice the new thing. He says, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? But our perceptions are sometimes awfully poor and weak. Sometimes we're just not paying attention at all. God calls us to new things. Well, what is the future for Christ's church? I couldn't tell you what it all is. We're living into it. I could tell you one of the new things that is springing forth in Christ's church has been springing forth in the last 18 months or so, and it is the care team ministry led by Mike Case. Mike, you told us at the last care team meeting, how many contacts was it that we've had? Phone calls, letters, personal visits. Was it
1,800?
Around 1,800 in around 18 months, which is really incredible and represents the work of a ton of people. Yeah, praise the Lord. Sharing together for the ministry. It's a new thing. Mike shared a story with me. I said, Mike, I love the story. I got to capture it on film. I want to be able to share it with all of us. He sat down in my study to share this story about something that, you know, as the leader of congregational care, he also found himself a recipient of care in a way that touched him profoundly. God is doing new things among us. Let's hear the story. Now, typical language to call people to be attentive to something like that would be, pay attention! Or the song, be still and know that I am God. Or slow down and smell the... Yeah, those things. But instead of that, we get a very interesting and unconventional way to be present in the now in Isaiah chapter 43. It is to practice praise and generosity. For Israel's worship, there was no separation of one and the other. When they came to worship, there were sacrifices and offerings that were part of it. God speaks of Israel, the people whom I formed for myself so that they might declare my praise. Yet you didn't call upon me, O Jacob, but you've been weary of me. You didn't bring me your sheep for burnt offerings or honor me with your sacrifices. I haven't burdened you with offerings or wearied you, but you've burdened me with your sins. You wearied me with your iniquities. I am he who blots out your transgressions for my own sake. I will not remember your sins. And here, as God calls Israel to remember him and return to practicing worship, it's the only way they're going to be able to perceive the new thing that's springing forth is to practice worship and generosity. God reminds them, I haven't burdened you. But so often when we think about the generosity side of our worship, and we think about biblical language like tithe, 10%, oh my goodness, burden, capital B, I mean, you know, the whole thing, it's big, it's huge, 10% is a lot. All I can say is it's in the book. And in my own life and practice, there have been times when, for me, it has felt like a burden because times were really tough and tight. But over a lifetime of practicing it, I found it to be an incredible blessing. To tithe and to give beyond the tithe. It has reoriented my life toward God in ways that are profound, in ways that have changed me inside out. Why should we make time? That would be God's call to give time to God on the Sabbath. Why should we make time for those who love God? Why should making time for those who love us best be burdensome? Why should giving gifts to those who give to us the best be an inheritance? Because the issue is not really about our time or our money, it's about our faith. The issue is not really about our time or our money, it's about our hope. The issue is not really about our time or money, but our love. And the prophet Isaiah calls Israel to a renewed relationship with God, to faith, hope, and love that perceives what God is doing now and embraces God in worship with generosity. And that's why appropriate talk about generosity, and there is certainly inappropriate talk about it, but appropriate talk about generosity is about souls, not about funding. It is about godliness. Because God is a generous God, not about money. It is about mission. It is not about survival. You see, God doesn't really need our money. God says the cattle on 1,000 hills are mine. It's one of the Psalms. You know, I think, well, what did those farmers think about that cattle? They thought it was money. But here God's claiming it. And God claims all we are and all we have. And God is a giver. We want to become more godly, more like God. We learn to grow in what the scripture calls the grace of giving. Because we have a glimpse of the future God has for us. And we learn to say to the prophet, the best is
yet to come.
Let's try that again. We say with the prophet, the best is yet to come. So I have four things for you today. Practical things. One is practice thankfulness. It's seasonal. It's biblical. Give thanks in all circumstances, the scriptures say. Not because all circumstances are good, but because it's a spiritual practice that shapes our lives to pay attention to what God is doing, not just to the evil that is part of life. Give thanks. Practice giving thanks. Take one of these blank leaves. We got a whole bunch of them here. Bring it home and fill both sides of it with stuff for which you are thankful. Practice giving. Secondly, imagine the future that God has for you. Behold, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Don't you perceive it? Imagine it. Think about it. Think about it in the shower. Think about it when you lie down in bed to go to sleep at night. If you get a glimpse of something, write it down. 2 weeks from now, we're going to be talking specifically about our future as a congregation together. And So I want you to spend some time praying and thinking about it.